Okay, guys, now that we got everything measured up, cleaned up, looking real good, almost ready for reassembly once we get everything totally put back together, get some new gaskets, be good to go. Probably going to run an MLS head gasket in here, probably because the paper gaskets, they work. They're good to cinch down, be good for one time. The MLS stuff, you can use them several times. Don't have to worry about it. Excuse me. As long as you don't pinch them down too far, you know, annihilate them essentially. When you take them back out, hit them with a good coat of copper spray. They're good to go. They last. They work. If you have to reuse them at the racetrack for one or two times, it's not going to really be the worst thing. Especially with these. They're not liquid cooled. We don't have to worry about water getting in the cylinders. There's no liquid in this engine except for a little bit of gasoline and a little bit of oil. That'll all stay separate. We don't have to worry about that getting in here. So, next place we're going to go is this manifold. I do make these manifolds. I've made several now. This one, most of the ones I've done for a while now, I set them up with the T4 flange or the T3 flange. And this flange lines up with many turbos now. I did one in the past that had a Subaru flange on it. Small Subaru flange, a 3-bolt flange. That's why I like these big ones. They're a nice big 4-bolt flange. They lock them down good. Ain't got to worry about it. The Subaru stuff works good too. And there's many turbos available for that also. Different sizes. Quite a few different ones. I like the TD04 stuff. Or the TD04 or 3 really is the best, I think, for anything over 600 cc's, TD04 is totally fine. With this setup, I don't have to worry about it moving around with the 4 bolts. It locks it in real tight. There's many different gaskets and flanges and all the goodies available for this setup. So if you want to adapt this to something else, it's not a problem. They now have adapters for this flange to a Subaru flange. It's a little short adapter. You can bolt it right on, put whatever turbo you want to run. Works out great. So I like this setup. These are actually a factory, well, not a factory. It's an aftermarket set of Honda CB pipes that I cut the head pipes off of, cut them down short. I use a manifold that brings them all together. I weld all that up. Get it all fitting perfect. Works out real nice. You can see in here, that's what we're going to do today. It's not much fun. What we got to do, I made this knowing that it still needs a little bit of work in here. Still needs to be ported. There's quite an edge right there. When the exhaust comes out, the exhaust is going to come out of the cylinder head right here. It'll come out and go into these 4 ports. It'll flow down. It'll be one at a time. It'll flow down, come up, come around here, and come up out through here. When it comes out of here, it'll go in right here into the turbo. So we need this flow to be spot on. No hiccups, no ridges, no extra anything in the way. We want that heat to come straight into that turbine. The more of this heat that we can get into that turbine, the better it's going to work, period. Especially for a high revving motorcycle engine. We want it in there. We want to light that thing off. We want it to blast. Rip it hard. That's why we're doing this. Most of this stuff, I'm really not too worried about machining, fitting. My dad was a machinist. I could show you guys here. 1 second. Love my dad a lot. I miss him a lot, too. You guys can see, that's a drill bit. My dad was a machinist for Olin Tool and Die for a long time. He made many of my custom drill bits in the past. If I needed a drill bit, I just told him what size and he'd make it, and it was about the most amazing thing ever. Just touch it and just blast holes like you wouldn't believe. Then he was a machinist for another quite large organization. It's called Washington University. He worked for many of their scientists. They would research and come up with ideas. And if if he could make it happen, he would, which he really could. It was amazing some of the stuff that he did for those professors. He had a little shop down, well, massive shop down in the basement where they'd come down, ask him to do what he wanted to do. They'd make it happen. So essentially, I grew up on a Bridgeport mill and in the cabinets putting away all his tooling for, he had many different machines, grinders, lathes. Probably the coolest machine I think he had was an Akuma CNC lathe. He was a programmer. He could program in all the CNC, put a piece of stock in that lathe, and man, it would just go to cutting like crazy. When he worked for Olin Tool and Die, he ran a turret lathe. I think he ran a turret lathe with, either a 14 or an 18 spot tool post. Imagine a job running 14 tools on a lathe, pumping out parts. Back then for Olin, that was for the war effort. Thanks, guys. Thanks, Dad. Man, y'all did it. Wow. So, since I grew up machining, throwing metal, love all that stuff. That's why this one has waited until now. Doing the fine machining on this really high-end, or, you know, high-tensile steel, the shavings come off super thin, really, really sharp, and they will poke into your skin like you wouldn't believe. If you just touch them wrong, man, they're in you. Had two now in my eyeballs. Not fun. Don't recommend it. Be careful with this stuff, guys. We're going to take it downstairs. Way too clean up here for all this. We're going to take it downstairs. You cover it up. Put some glasses on. Especially how I got in my eye before. I had glasses on. I was touching around my face with my glasses on, messing with my glasses, and the stuff's on my hands. Don't do that. I had to learn the hard way. Please. Less you can be at the optometrist, the better. Trust me. Okay. We're going to get this fit up. Let me just show you guys here too in the light what we're going to do. We can prop this up and get a little light on here so you guys can really see what we're going to do. Let me show you. So, got another light here too. Yeah, we can really see. See down in there? That's where the four tubes come in. They all come out there. Essentially, what we got to do, if you look in here on the edge, see where there's more room that could actually be opened up for this flange? All the way around, pretty much. Still needs some digging and cutting and redoing. We're going to taper these edges so they really flow down into this port. As you see, this one down here, it's a bit bigger. So we can really open this one up, make it flow real nice into that turbo, not have to worry about it in the extra heat. Right now, with the way these tubes are set up, if all that exhaust came down and hit this flange, it would hang up right here. You can see the difference there? It's not a lot, but it's definitely enough. That if that wasn't tapered down to where it met this opening, it would definitely cause a restriction. Some restrictions are okay. You don't have to worry about every single thing. But that one's big enough that we're going to bring it down, taper it into there, really let that heat, that fire. Essentially at that point, it's fire. We want that fire hitting that turbine and making it spin. Here we go. Okay, get all covered up here and get my gloves on. Got my glasses on too. Got my headlight. We can really see down in there. Take a look and see what we got doing here. Yeah, just a little bit here. A little more here. A little bit on the sides. Okay. Get us a towel here so we don't scoot around too much. Almost need something to hold that up so we can get after it. see if this will prop it up enough here. Yep, that looks out. That looks good. Okay. As you see, we're going to use our carbide burr again. This one really digs in there good. This is one I use for aluminum too, but it is actually made for steel. Luckily, it's deep enough and the burrs are cut wide enough that it doesn't clog up with the aluminum. Some bits will. This one, actually, that's why I love it. It works out great. Spins nice and good. Battery's charged. Let's go. Need to find a little different angle to get at it there. Really need it just like that would probably be the best angle I could really get in there. Let me see if I can find something to hold it up here. What to do?
Just good.
You see how fine these filings are, guys? See how fine that is? Super duper fine. That will go into your skin like a hypodermic needle. Be very careful with this stuff. Very, very careful. Okay, we can see now. Got her in there good. Starting to ease that edge. I don't know if you guys can see that or not. Basically trying to ease that edge down into where the meets the tubing. Looking good so far. And now we got it down close enough that what I like to do is come in here with this. And let me see here, since we're doing steel, we can put a little more aggressive. I think we're going to go with that one. I think that's 80 grit. We can go with a little more aggressive grit now. See, we put it on there like that. It's got a tensioner here. Pop the tensioner. Center it back up. Make sure it's good. I give it a couple bumps just to make sure it's centered. See how it stays centered there? Adjust it here, yeah. All right, looking good. And of course, this, it has an auto tension, so we're good to go there. This adjusts the angle, which it works at. I just like it straight. If I need to dip it a little bit, I can. Again, looking great. Okie dokie. Now this bottom one. This is the deep one. At least the one we have the most to remove on. You see, I got a pretty good lip there. Ooh, that's feeling that's feeling butchery now. Alright, let's do some digging here and see what we get. Let me see the best way to hold this. This is my welding holder. It's just a good old magnet. What I need is my 90 degree magnet to stick in here right now. That would work perfect. But of course, don't have it down here. Enough to hold it. Maybe I should just come out here to the edge, dip down, and just work it just like that. Probably work fine. Get my stool here. Yeah, now I can see it. Uh-oh, battery's going dead.
New battery.
See those fine filings, guys? Those are the ones you got to be careful of. And there's a bunch more in there too. There's a bunch more. Look at all that. We are getting there though. That is looking beautiful now. I say let's hit it with a little sandpaper here and see what it does. I don't wanna fall and miss my way. Sometimes you gotta stop and find your way. That's what happens when you dig too hard. Pressing a little hard, trying to really dig down in it. Popped it off. Still good, I could put it back on there. Actually, I think I'm gonna change the grit because I got most of it worked out of there now. I'm gonna go down to, let's see what the next step, yeah, this is 120. That was 80. Let's step it down to 120 here, see if we can give it a little more shine. Get her centered up there. Yep, good to go. Okay. Make sure it stays centered there. Yep, looking good. That's what we needed the whole time. Alright, yeah. Let's see if I can prop this up and let you guys get in here and take a little look, see? She's an RC car tire. Oh, look at that. That is looking so good now. Let you guys get in here and see if we can actually get a little light on it. See how that's blended together now? The flange blends directly down into the pipe now. There's no step, there's no hiccups, there's no burrs, there's no none of that. If you see there on top, yeah, that's looking great now. Absolutely great. Just a little bit of touch up on this side over here. You see here, see there's still a little lip down in there. If you guys can see, a little piece of a lip there. Just need to get that buzz down here, we'll be good to go. Awesome. Yeah. Okay. Oh yeah. So much better, guys. So much better. Looking great now. Heck yeah. Okay. That is looking wonderful. Actually, there's still just a bit more right there. Let's see if I can hit that just a little more right there. Yep, that is looking muy bueno. Yes. Okay. Opened up our porch size just a little bit. Actually, looks like I need to work on this wall just a little bit just to square it up all the way. But didn't open it up too much, so it's not going to be bigger than the turbo. Once again, we don't want heat hanging up on that edge. We want this to almost be just a bit smaller than the opening in the turbo. So it opens up and goes right into the turbine. Heat across turbine. Spool it up. Yeah. Okay, we're starting this wall. Yep. That squares it up all the way around. Looking great.
Okay, next thing we got to do, you guys can see, I started to touch up this flange on my flat plate with a piece of sandpaper to see where we're at. And you can see I got coverage all the way around, but all four of these edges. It's slightly warped. That's okay. When you weld these big flanges, they don't like to stay flat. Just need to buzz that down, and we will be good to go. Really, right now, it would work perfect because this inner part is really the only part that needs to seal anyway with the gasket on the turbine or on the turbo housing. Really, it's okay. But the more that you can get to really seat flat, better off it's going to be. Let's try. Okay, what we got, guys? It's just a... Actually, you know what? I was thinking this had a drill chuck on it, but it's missing. Not sure what I did with the drill chuck. We'll just see if we can get that to stick on there. And what I want to do... There we go. See if we can lap this down a little bit. So we can see how bad it really is. I may take it to my buddy's machine shop and have it cut flat. No, actually, wow. Okay, yeah, that's actually looking a lot better than what I thought, guys. You can see we have coverage. You can see with the sandpaper, it's showing me exactly where I'm not touching. And it looks like we're touching all the way across. I think it's going to be good. Yeah, that's going to be fine. Just that little bit over here where it's not touching. Gasket will seal that up 100% because it's touching all the way around. Yeah. Wonderful. Okay. Turbo manifold 100% done and ready to bolt on with the ceramic coating. Wonderful. Okay, now that we got the manifold all cleaned up and looking wonderful, it's going to flow like gangbusters now. Light this turbo off like we really want to do. Next episode here, we're going to get this fit up to the head. And I'm going to show you guys what's up with the turbocharger. Give you guys a little info on how we're going to do the oiling system. The restrictor. There's going to be actually two restrictors. There's one in the turbo. There's going to be one in the line. It would be much easier if the bike was somewhat taken apart at this point. It's completely finished. It's turbocharged with an engine. That's all done. If you guys have seen in my other vids, this is a completely new setup. Had this, building all this for this, essentially. The bike is still together. I can't really take it apart right now. I know some people know me. I've built quite a few bikes in the past. I've built several for a pretty cool show we have here in town. It's a nationwide deal. People from all over the country will be here. And my good buddy that runs the show, he likes to pick bikes that pretty much have just come together. He doesn't want to see some old stuff that everybody's seen. If we can see some new stuff that's going to just blow everybody's mind, that's what the Cycle Showcase is all about. My Turbo 750 got invited to the showcase. Wow. I've been there in the past. My very first land speed bike was the Turbo Yamaha. It got invited too. We went center stage. Man, it was an awesome show. I think that might have been the very first Cycle Showcase many years ago. Many, many years ago. Got to go again because I restored a Harley. It's a 1959 Sportster. Restored it for a very good buddy. That bike was actually invited without even us knowing. It kind of got out that it was getting restored. I got a call and said, if the bike is done, it has a spot at the showcase. I was like, whoa, let me finish it. I was one day out from finishing it. Finished it, got it on stage. Man, a wonderful time. Can't even, it was so cool. This year, I finished the bike. Once again, the word kind of got out. I was let know that it's invited and I need to
do what I can to get it there. So I can't take it apart. Can't work on it. Right now I'm actually cleaning it, making sure it's all going to be good, because it's going to be up on a podium and it's going to be live for everyone to see. I'll add a little link in at the end for the showcase and the date and the event time. Once again, just wow, guys. Wow. Whew. This has all become so much more than I ever would have guessed. I wanted to build a cool Honda, put a turbo on it, make it sing some turbo noises. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo. And it's all come to this. Now I'm doing all this. This bike might go 200. It's what I want to do. It's what I've always wanted. I've always loved going fast. Been fast several times now. Had several turbo bikes. I've been over 200. I want to do it again. It happened so fast. And it was over. Like, oh man, I just wanted to keep going. Can I just keep going? So we're going to do it again, guys. With a Honda this time. Good old Honda power. Yeah, love me a good old Honda. So, to make all this happen, I can't really afford all this. I can't really do all this. I'm trying to work it out to where I can get the bike to the showcase and actually have it on stage and beautiful for everyone to see. I've started a PayPal. I've also started a Patreon, guys. Any help is gonna finish this project. I really do need the help, I must say. I'm not really one to ask for help. I'm kind of one of the worst about that. I help people. It's what I do. I've been a master mechanic for a long time. I fix problems. If there's a problem, come see Ben. We get it fixed. I need some help this time, guys. Go figure. But in the end, y'all are going to see some amazing stuff with this. I guarantee. If you want to help, please do. If not, just watch and learn. That's all I'm trying to do is learn a little bit too. The more we can learn, move on, and have fun in life and go fast and make boost and do it with a carburetor, not fuel injection. I think we've all kind of learned computers are okay for some things. Great for watching YouTube. Carburetors work. Have for a long, long time. Good old organized fuel leak. Thanks, guys. Like, share, comment, subscribe. Way more to come. Thanks, guys.